Can you really tell a real diamond from a fake one? In this video, we're going to run 5 tests to show you how. Keep in mind that some of these tests might be inconclusive on their own, so it's always a good idea for you to run multiple tests to determine if your diamond is real or fake. Number 1, the water test. At 3.5 times the density of water, diamonds are pretty dense minerals. This means if you drop one in water, it'll sink. When it comes to fake diamonds, on the other hand, you may have heard that some may actually float or stay suspended in the water. This is simply not true. Even quartz and glass are denser than water, so a fake diamond made out of these will sink too. When dealing with one of the most popular diamond substitutes around, like the synthetic cubic zirconia or CZ, it's actually heavier and denser than a diamond, so it'll sink even faster. Let's see that again in slow motion. Notice the difference? Despite all of this, it's really easy to make a mistake and obtain misleading results when conducting the water test, so we recommend that you also run more tests like the following. Number 2, the scratch test. Diamonds are not just dense, they're hard. In fact, they're the hardest substance known to man, scoring a perfect 10 on the famous Mohs hardness scale. This simply means that a diamond will scratch or cut another substance that's not as hard as it, like glass. Even though it's a bit difficult to press this 1-carat diamond firmly against the champagne bottle, it scratches the bottle pretty easily, creating a deeper and deeper groove into the glass the more we rub it up and down. The fake diamond also scratches the glass surface, but not as easily as the diamond. That's because our cubic zirconia is also harder than glass. But what happens when we try to scratch the diamond with the CZ? Nothing, not even a single scratch. Now let's reverse the roles and attempt the same thing and see what happens. Our poor diamond simulant is all scratched up. It wasn't even a fair fight. And you probably guessed it by now, only a diamond can scratch another diamond. Number 3, newspaper test. For this test, we won't need a newspaper, just an X or a dot on a piece of paper. Diamonds refract or bend a portion of the light that hits them, while glass and certain diamond imitations, like cubic zirconia, bend relatively less light. This means that when you place a diamond of decent quality over text, it will refract light so intensely that you really won't be able to make out what you're reading at all. On the other hand, doing the same thing with a diamond simulant like CZ will have a totally different effect. Notice that the fake diamond is a lot more transparent. That's because it doesn't refract light as well as a diamond. Do you notice the difference? Number 4, the flame test. Here's an interesting one. Think you could burn a diamond? It takes nature billions of years to make diamonds 93 miles below the Earth's surface. That's where tiny gemstones experience extreme pressures and scorching temperatures above 1,000 degrees Celsius. But after they're made, can these little suckers really take the heat? Let's see. We're going to put a real diamond and a fake one in the fire and heat them up for 20 seconds before rapidly cooling them in a glass of water. Let's do the real diamond first. Oops, right away our diamond turned black from the heat. Did we damage it? Let's cool it down and see. By its outward appearance, it seems that our diamond suffered some damage. Let's try to clean it up, wiping it with a little alcohol. Voila! No damage whatsoever. Now let's see how our cubic zirconia reacts to the fire. While the diamond wasn't affected by the rapid change in temperature, a fake diamond made out of glass, quartz, or cubic zirconia will shatter. This is some real damage. Check out the side-by-side comparison. Anyone ready to put their diamond to the test? Number 5, conductivity test. Moissanites are considered by many to be the best fake diamonds around, and like diamonds, they're very hard, scoring a 9.25 on the Mohs scale. That's higher than any gemstone used in jewelry besides diamonds. Despite their similarities, most natural diamonds do not conduct electricity like moissanites do. So let's run this test. We'll need a conductivity tool like the Gemoro Ultra Tester 3 Plus. A lot of jewelers and diamond buyers use tools like this, and you can easily find one on Amazon. We'll test our 1-carat diamond first. Green, it's a diamond. And now for our 5-carat moissanite. Our conductivity tool detects it easily. And trust me, you don't want to make a mistake at a 5-carat level. A natural diamond of this size can be tens to 100s times more expensive than a moissanite, which might translate into hundreds of thousands of dollars. You owe it to yourself to be able to tell them apart. Here's a bonus treat. We already know that diamonds are the hardest substance on the planet, but does that mean they can be struck with a hammer and survive? Breaking a good quality diamond of this size can easily make this a $5,000 experiment. What the f***? What just happened? Don't worry. I promise we just sacrificed a cubic zirconia, not a diamond. Even though diamonds are the hardest mineral on Earth, remember that the hardness measures the ability to resist scratching, not a blow from a hammer. Tenacity, not hardness, is what measures a material's resistance to blows, and in this respect, diamonds are considered brittle. So while steel won't scratch a diamond, it'll certainly shatter if struck at the right angle, especially at the tip. Let us know what you thought of our real versus fake tests. If there's another test you would like to see, let us know as well. Leave a comment below and click the subscribe button if you enjoy content like this. See you next time.